Hello friends, welcome to Vidya's cooking channel. I'm back with a new recipe. Today I'm going to be showing you how I prepared lemon mutton. This is a very simple recipe if you follow a few steps. Here I'll be using mutton chops to prepare this recipe. Mutton chops is from Mimo Meats. I did do an unboxing video in my previous video. You can just visit that video and see more about Mimo Meats. This is traditionally or 100% certified jet cut meat. I've washed it, drained it and reserved. Here I've finely chopped all the ingredients: onion, mint, coriander, ginger, garlic, we'll require curry leaves, dried red chilies, lime, finely chopped chilies, ginger and garlic paste. I'll be using lemon flavor, or you can use lemon oil. We need yogurt, chili powder, turmeric powder and salt. I'll also be using curry powder, garam masala, coriander powder, some cumin powder and pepper powder. All the ingredients used in this recipe, friends, will be listed in the description box below this video, or you can click the icon above this video which will direct you to my blog. In the blog I've posted a detailed written recipe. I'm going to start marinating the meat first. So the meat is thoroughly washed and I've added it to a large mixing bowl. I'll be adding the cumin powder, garam masala, coriander powder, pepper powder. I'll be adding the turmeric powder, chili powder and salt. We'll also add the ginger and garlic paste and the yogurt. We need to marinate the meat so that the meat softens a bit, and then we'll be cooking it in the pressure cooker. They did send me chili powder, organic pink salt and turmeric powder. It is very nice of Mimo Meats to send me the prep ingredients also. I must thank them. We thoroughly enjoyed the meat. The meat was very good in terms of flavor and taste. It was very nice and tender. I've heated a pressure cooker. So after 30 minutes, I've transferred the meat to the pressure cooker. Once you add your meat to the pressure cooker, just allow it to sit for 2 minutes. Then you keep turning it and frying it for 2 minutes on each side so that it's fried well. Here what I've done, friends, I've not wasted any of the marination. I've added half a glass of water to the marination, diluted it. We'll be adding it to the meat once it's fried, and we'll also add another glass of water to the meat so that it cooks evenly. So now once the meat has fried, I'll add the diluted marination and half a glass of extra water, half to one glass of extra water for the meat to cook. We'll place the lid and the whistle. We'll cook this on high flame for 4 whistles. Because the water is very hard where I stay, it takes longer period of time to cook. But Mimo Meats was cooked perfectly in just 4 whistles. I removed it from the flame and checked it once. If it was not cooked, I wanted to place it again for another 2 whistles, but it did not happen. It was very well cooked. So now I'll place this on medium flame and allow that excess moisture to completely evaporate. So we'll place this on medium flame, keep turning it. And when you're preparing this, the meat will become fork tender. So I just kept turning it and cooking it, making sure it doesn't burn. The moisture has completely evaporated at this point. Once the moisture from the meat has evaporated, remove from the flame, allow it to sit for some time so that you prepare the masala and then you can toss the meat. Now I placed a wok on medium flame. The wok is nice and hot. I've added ghee and oil. Once the ghee and oil has reached temperature, place this on medium flame. Nothing should be done on high flame. I've added the finely chopped chilies, onion, finely chopped ginger, garlic, the dried red chilies, curry leaves, all at once. We need to fry all of this till the raw flavor reduces. So all the ingredients used in this recipe and the stepwise written recipe is on my blog. The blog link will be in the description box below this video, or you can click the icon above this video which will direct you to my blog. For regular updates, do like me and follow me on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. All these recipes are translated and posted in Tamil language. The Tamil channel link will also be in the description box below this video. Now I'll be adding the finely chopped chilies, and we need to fry the onion. I've added the leftover garlic and ginger. I wanted to garnish that, but ultimately I ended up adding it to the onions and frying it. So once the onion, ginger and garlic has fried well, at this point I've added the cooked meat. Now at this point I've added the cooked meat. If there is excess masala from the meat, add that masala also and fry it. You don't have to add any water at this point. Just keep tossing it and frying it on medium flame. So you can see the meat is frying very well. The color has already changed. It's got a very nice color at this point. So I'm going to be adjusting the salt in the meat, and I'll be frying the meat on medium flame for 2 minutes on each side. Just keep tossing it and frying it. Now once the meat has fried for 2 minutes on each side, at that point I'll be adding the pepper powder and half a lime. Now from here you have to be very fast. Place the flame on medium high, not fully high, place it on medium high, and then you'll need to add your lemon flavor or your lemon oil and little bit of the lemon skin, which is the rind portion. I'll be adding, so 2 drops of lemon flavor is what I've added. Now I'll toss the meat in the masala. My lemon mutton is done. I'm going to be serving this as hot as possible. Just fry it for 2 minutes, not more than that. You need to add your mint and coriander. Toss it once more. It's ready. So now the lemon mutton, I'm going to be serving it. This pairs well with the mutton biryani or your ghee rice. Give this recipe a try and post your comments, friends. If you enjoyed watching this video recipe, give me a thumbs up and subscribe to me for more recipes. I'll be seeing you soon with the next recipe video. This is Vidya Lakshmi. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.